Assalamualaikum, my dear students. Welcome to your chemistry class of standard 10. Today, I will discuss about saturated open chain hydrocarbon, that is alkene. I have divided my lecture on alkene in two parts. In first part, I will discuss about the homologous series, definition of alkene, alkyl radical and the most important naming of alkene. And in second part, I will discuss about the preparation process and chemical reaction of alkene. So, let's start the class. At first, homologous series. A series of organic compounds with similar chemical properties in which member differs from one another by additional methylene group is called homologous series. That means homologous series is actually a group of organic compounds where their chemical properties are same, their constituent elements are same, and they have a common general formula, and they have a difference between two adjacent compound is by this methylene group. That means between two consecutive groups there is difference only CH2 group. This is called methylene group. Follow the properties of homologous series, then it will be more clear to you. Each series has a general formula. That means all the members of a homologous series can be represented by a general formula. All members possesses the same functional group. That means they have a common functional group. It is the functional group that gives the series its characteristic reaction. For the presence of this functional group, all members of a homologous series will show the similar chemical reaction. Members of the same homologous series have similar chemical properties and methods of preparation. Since they have a similar chemical properties, so their preparation process will be same. The chemical formula increases by methylene group from one member to next of the series. That means between two consecutive members, they have a difference of this group. There is a gradual change in physical properties from one member to the next. The most common example of this is the increasing melting and boiling points as we go up a series. The reason for this is the molecules get larger. That means from one member to the next member, their molecular masses will be increased, so their molecules will be larger. For this, their physical or chemical properties will be gradually changed. Now follow the example, then it will be more clear to you. For example, alkene. Alkene is a homologous series and its common general formula is CnH2n+2. This is the general formula of alkene, and its functional group is carbon-carbon single bond. Now follow the example, methane, ethane, propane, butane, and also more hydrocarbon of alkene. They are what? Member of alkene homologous series. So their homologous series name is alkene, and they are the members. They are called homologo. And follow here, they have a common general formula. When carbon number is 1, then hydrogen number will be what? 4, methane. When carbon number is 2, then there will be hydrogen number will be 6. So C2H6. So by using this common formula, just putting the value of the carbon, you can easily determine the chemical formula of the members of this series. And follow here, they have a difference of methylene group CH2 between two consecutive members. For example, methane, ethane. methane CH4 and ethane C2H6. So they have a difference between CH2, that means one carbon atom and two hydrogen atom. Follow here, there is difference one carbon atom and two hydrogen atom. Also between this ethane and propane there is difference one carbon atom and two hydrogen atom. So like this way they have a difference in each molecular series between two members, they have a difference by CH2 group. For example, alcohol, they have a common general formula CnH2n+1OH, and OH is actually its functional group. That means all member of this alcohol homologous series bears this functional group, and for the presence of this OH functional group, they are showing the similar chemical properties. And also you can find out the chemical formula of the one member by putting from calculating the general formula. For example, propanol means carbon will be 3, so if carbon is 3 then hydrogen will be what? Hydrogen will be 7, C3H7OH, like this way. Now also alcohol, alkene, alkyne, carboxylic acids, aldehyde, they are all homologous series and at the example of homologous series. Alcohol, it is also called alkanol. Carboxylic acid, it is also called alkanoic acid. You will learn this in next lectures. Aldehyde, or it is also called alkanal. So these are the actually member of example of homologous series, and they are the example of members of a specific homologous series. Now you will know about alkene is a homologous series of saturated organic compound. Actually the hydrocarbons which have carbon-carbon single bond in their carbon chain are called alkenes. That means all the members of this homologous series contains carbon-carbon single bond. Now follow some characteristics of alkene. The general formula of alkene is CnH2n+2 or RH. R is actually alkyl radical, I will tell about this. That means CnH2n+1 hydrogen, except one hydrogen, the residue part is also denoted by R. It contains mainly carbon and hydrogen atom, but in case of substituted alcohol another atom may be present there. That means there main constituent elements are carbon and hydrogen. Of this class, that means of this homologous series, carbon 1 to carbon 4 compounds are gases. That means methane, ethane, propane and butane, these four alkenes are gaseous substance. And from carbon 5 to carbon 17, that means from pentane to up to 17 compounds are exist in liquid state, and carbon 18 and onwards compounds are colorless, odorless, waxy solids. That means these are the actually their physical states, and you have to remember this because sometimes from here MCQ question will come. Mainly alkenes are used as fuel, you have seen in my last class. They are also called paraffin. They means alkenes are also called paraffin due to its less affinity to react with other substances. They are called paraffin because they have a very less tendency to react with other substances. Why? Because alkenes contains carbon-carbon single bond, and which is very very strong. Carbon-carbon single covalent bond, but they are very strong, and it is very difficult to take place in a reaction breaking this strong bond. For this, they have a very less tendency to react or with other compounds. They show reaction, just they show combustion reaction or they show reaction with chlorine, which I will discuss in my next lecture. But most of the alkene cannot react with any other elements. That means they have a very less tendency to showing reaction. For this they are called paraffin. Paraffin means less affinity to react. Now alkyl group. Before alkane you have to know also about alkyl group. Alkyl group is what? Alkyl group is actually a radical that has general formula CnH2n+1, formed by removing a hydrogen atom from alkane. That means when one hydrogen atom is replaced from an alkane, then the produced part is known as alkyl group. And in naming the last part of this alkane member, ANE replaced by YL, IL. For example, this is ethane, CH3, CH3, that means C2H6. This is called ethane, isn't it? But when one hydrogen is replaced from here, then it will become CH3, CH2. So its name will be ethyl. It was ethane, alkane, but when one hydrogen is removed from here, then it will form a alkyl radical called ethyl. Like this way, follow here, methane. When one hydrogen atom is replaced from methane, then it will become methyl radical. Now also there are different alkyl radical. For example, propyl. From propane, one hydrogen is removed. Propane means carbon 3, C2 carbon 3, C3H8, isn't it? C3H8, according to the common general formula of alkane, CnH2n+6. So C3H8, so there will be C3, 1, 2, 3 and H7, because one hydrogen is removed. For this, it will produce propyl alkyl radical, butyl alkyl radical, like this way. Now we will learn about naming of alkanes. This is very, very important and very, very interesting also. So you have to give full attention for determination of naming of alkanes. In case of a straight line alkane or linear alkane, that means which are not branched, in this case we easily, counting the number of carbon, we easily write the UPAC name of this alkane. UPAC name means, UPAC means International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry, which is actually an institution which are dealings with all chemical relatives. So chemistry relatives works they have done, and they are actually recognized, or they recognize all things related with chemistry internationally. So how can we write the UPAC name of linear chain alkane members? Follow here. When carbon number is 1, then its word root, that means Greek word, its word root name is meth. When carbon number is 1, then its word root will be meth. And if it is alkane series, then its name will be methane. Methane. When carbon number is 2, then its word root will be eth. And in alkane, or for alkane series, homologous series, its name will be ethane. And if it is alkene series, then its name will be ethene. But when carbon number is 2, then its word root will be eth. So like this way, you have to just memorize the word root name for the specific carbon number. For example, for 3 carbon atoms, its name will be prof, then for 4 but, accordingly for 7 hept, for 8 oct, for 9 non, and for 10 tec. And for the alkane homologous series, their name will be decane, nonen, octane, for hexane, for 5 carbons pentane, like this way. Follow here, pentane. Pentane means when carbon number is 5, and according to general formula CnH2n+2, its hydrogen atoms will be 12. So when you will see this type of structural formula, that means carbon 5 and here 3 times CH2. You can write like this way, or you can write CH2 bond, CH2 bond, CH2 like this way. But there carbon will be 5 and hydrogen will be what? Total 12. So in this type of chemical compounds, you just directly write down their name pentane, because they are not branched, they are linear structure of alkane. So like this way you can easily, on the depending on the number of carbon atoms, you can write their name, EUPAC name. But if the alkanes are substituted or branched alkane, in that cases you have to learn how can you write their name. So now we will learn about the naming of substituted alkane. Actually, in the name of an alkane there are two parts, that is prefix and word root. Word root already you have understood. Word root means which are actually depending on the carbon number. And prefix, to determine the prefix you have to follow some rules. At first you have to numbering the longest carbon chain. I have said in all alkane members except methane they have a carbon chain. So when we want to write the name of a branched alkane or substituted alkane, in that cases at first we have to number in the longest carbon chain, and for this we have to add the value at the position of carbon in which substitution occurs from both sides, and lowest addition result will be granted for numbering. I will explain you showing the example. That means here we have to add the position of the substituted carbon and from both sides, and the lowest addition result, that means from the side in which lowest addition result we will get, we will numbering from that side. Or we can also follow some rules by which we can easily numbering the longest carbon chain. For example, numbering should be started from the side in which substitution is nearest the end. That means from the side substitution is started very nearer, or substitution is nearest, in that side numbering should be started. Or if in both sides it is same, that means if from the both side in same number of carbon substitution is started, in that cases more substitution will get priority. That means if in a carbon if there are more substitution occurs from the other side, in that side numbering should be started. Or according to alphabetical order numbering should be started like this way. I will explain following the example. Then if different groups are substituted, then according to alphabetical order prefix will write mentioning their carbon number. Now follow the example. Follow here. Dekho, this is the structural formula of a substituted alkane. Substituted alkane means when the hydrogen atom, one or more hydrogen atom, are substituted by different alkyl groups or any other groups, then that alkanes are known as substituted alkane, or we can say branched alkane. Now follow here. These are the methyl alkyl radical, these are ethyl C2H6, ethyl alkyl radical, isn't it? And this is the longest carbon chain. So at first we have to numbering the carbon chain. Follow here carbon numbering is started from this side. Why? Because follow here, I have said from the end by which the substitution is nearest. Follow here, in from this side in second carbon substitution is started, but from this side in third carbon substitution is started. For this numbering should be started from this side because this is nearest. Now follow here, how will we write the prefix? You have to mention the carbon position with the substitution group. Here substitution is methyl and this is ethyl, and these groups you have to write in alphabetical order. Alphabetical order means this is methyl M and this is ethyl E. So E is first and M is next. So at first you have to mention the position of this ethyl group. So and this ethyl is in third carbon from this side, third carbon. So you have to write 3-ethyl like this way, 3-ethyl, all will be in small letter, 3-ethyl. There are 2-methyl group, isn't it? And their carbon position is 2 and 3. So 2,3-dimethyl. Why dimethyl? Di means 2. So there are 2-methyl group. For this there is mentioned di. If there are 3, then we have to try for 4-tetra, for 5-penta, like this way. And that total number, and now word root is what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbon. So their word root will be meth, and this is the only carbon-carbon single bond, because this is since this is the alkane homologous series, for this its name will be pentane. So like this way you have to write the UPAC name of this substituted alkane, 3-ethyl 2,3-dimethyl pentane. Very easy, don't be worried. Now follow the another example. Follow here, this is the longest carbon chain, isn't it? And its total carbon number is 8, that means octane. Now, and also there are methyl substitution and also ethyl substitution. Now, why this carbon chain is numbering from this side? Because from both end we are observing the in second carbon their substitution occur, isn't it? So in this case we have to follow the first rule, that means we have to add the position of the substitution, position of carbon of the substitution. Follow here, there is from this side there is second two number position, also 3 position, also 5 position, also 7 position. That means if we add their position, then what will be the addition result? 5 plus 2 7 3 10 plus 7 17, isn't it? But if we numbering from this side, then what will happen? 2 2 plus 4 6 6 plus 6 12 12 plus 7 19. So in that cases name will be 4-ethyl 2,6,7-trimethyl octane, and their addition result will be 19. But what I have said, lowest addition result will be granted. So for this name will not be correct. This is the wrong name of this compound. This is the correct name, because their addition of position result is lowest. So this is the correct name, and if this name is you will write, then it will be wrong. Understood? Now follow more examples. You know that these are linear chains, so ethane, propane, you know. For example, follow here, 2,4-dimethylhexane. Hexane, why? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 carbons, so hexane. And numbering should be started from here, because from here substitution is nearest, and from here third carbon, so from in this side. That is 2 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. 2,4-dimethylhexane. Follow this. This is the 3 carbons. For this there is propane, and in second carbon from here both sides second carbon is methyl. For this 2-methyl propane. For this is also propane. This is also propane, because 3 carbons, but in second carbon there are more substitution, 2-methyl group are substituted. For this we have to mention like this way, 2,2, because in second carbon 2 methyls are substituted. 2,2-dimethylpropane. Now follow here, this is the not butane. Follow here, this is interesting. The longest chain seems of 4 carbons, isn't it? But this is not longest chain. Your longest chain will be this will be the longest chain, because if we take like this way, then it will chain of 5 carbons, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. For this you have to consider this chain is the longest chain, not this chain, and in that cases this methyl group will be substituted group. Now follow here, from this side in second carbon is substitution occur, and from this side in third carbon substitution occur. So from this side there will be started numbering. So in 2,3-dimethyl, this and this, 2,3-dimethyl pentane. Now follow here, this is same. If you consider 1, 2, 3, 4 butane, if you consider like this way, 1, 2, 3, 4 butane. So, 1, 2, 3, 4 butane. There will be actually wrong. There is written wrong. So, you have to write what? And from this side in second carbon, from this side in second carbon there is started substitution, and if you consider this, then 1, 2, 3 third carbon, if you consider this 1, 2, 3 third carbon, so from this side numbering should be started. So 1, 2 second carbon, 2 ethyl, ethyl is alphabetical order, 2 ethyl, 2 methyl, there is actually butane, there will be butane, not propane, there will be butane for 4 carbon. Now follow here, there is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, so we will not take this from, if we take like this way, then it will be longest chain, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, so this is the longest chain for this, this is known as heptane. Now numbering 1, 2, 3 third carbon substitution started, and from this side 1, 2, 3 third carbon substitution started, but here in third carbon only one substitution, but here in third carbon there are two substitutions. So from this side numbering should be started. So 1, 2, 3 three, 3, 3, 4, 5, 5, 3, 3, 5 trimethyl heptane. Longest chain will be what? This is the longest chain. So 3, 3, 4, 5, 5 trimethyl heptane. I hope you understood. Now follow the more example. Follow here. Now we will try to write the name. Follow here. From this side numbering should be started, and our word root will be what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So pentane, 2 methyl pentane. Very easy. Now follow here. At first you have to find the longest chain. If we know, consider like this way, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you can take this longest chain or this longest chain, no problem. But numbering should be started from 1, 2, 3 third carbon, and from this side 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So from this side. So now 1, 2, 3. 3 ethyl CH2. 3 ethyl, and this is what group? Alkyl group. Propyl, because C3A is 7. This is the propyl alkyl group. 3 ethyl 3 propyl hexane. So name will be 3 ethyl 3 propyl hexane. Now follow this example. At first you have to consider the longest chain, and it will be the longest chain, and word root will be 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 decane. And here from fifth number carbon there is substitution, and here from fifth number carbon there is substitution, and also from both side two substitution occurs. Now we have to add the position number. So from this side there will be addition of position will be what? 5 5 10 plus 6 6 12 12 plus 10 22, and from this side 5 5 10 plus 6 6 2 12. From this side also same. Follow here, what interesting problems are there. So from both side their addition value of the position of substitution are also same. So in that cases, from which side you have to start the numbering? In that cases you have to follow the alphabetical order of the substitution group. Here substitution groups are methyl and ethyl, and alphabetical order, according to alphabetical order, ethyl will come first, isn't it? So from this you have to consider from this numbering. So 5 ethyl 5 6 6 trimethyl decane. So 5 ethyl 5 6 6 trimethyl decane. Now this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pentane, and from this side more substitution occurs. So 2, 2, 4 trimethyl pentane. 2, 2, 4. There will be 4. This is wrong. 2, 2, 4 trimethyl pentane, not 3. This is wrong written. So 2, 2, 4 trimethyl pentane. So like this way easily you can write the name of the alkanes. Now follow the another examples. Follow here. CH3 CH2 5 CH2 5 means there is written 5 times CH2 together. CH2 bond CH2 bond CH2 bond CH2. You can write, no problem, but also you can write like this way. So if there is 5 carbon, and so 1 5 6 7 8, so longest chain will be octane. And from this side numbering, because nearest the substitution, that is second, that is 2 methyl, number will be 2 methyl octane. Follow here. There is CH3 4, that means with this carbon 4 methyl groups are added. That means in carbon 4 hand, in 4 side there will be methyl group, isn't it? So if we take the longest chain like this way, then there will be 1, 2, 3 carbon propane, and in second carbon there are 2 methyl groups substituted. So like for this, its name will be 2,2-dimethylpropane, or also it is called neopentane. But no need, this is the UCAT name, so you will just learn this. Also in higher class you will learn this, how sometimes in another process their naming is isoneo, like this way. But just you have to know that dimethyl propane. In C number, follow here, 1, 2, 3, and there is also 3. That means in corner there is 1 methyl, and in upper side and lower side also 2 methyl groups are present. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, pentane. And from this side, second carbon more substitution occurs. For this, from this side numbering should be started. So 2, 2, 4 trimethyl pentane. 2, 2, 4 trimethyl pentane. Now here follow this, longest chain will be what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, isn't it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this is the longest chain, and from this side substitution occur. This is the third carbon, and from this side second carbon. So 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 5 dimethyl heptane. Now follow this figure. What a interesting. You have to consider the longest chain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. No. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It can be, because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. No, this is the longest carbon chain. 1, 10. So now we have to from which side? From this side, 4 number carbon. From this side also 4 number carbon, and more substitution occur from this side. So numbering should be started from this side. So like this way, there are which substitution groups are there? Methyl groups, also ethyl groups, also propyl group. So at first you have to mention ethyl group, E, alphabetical order. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 6 diethyl, 4, 6, 7 trimethyl, 5, 5 dipropyl decane, 4, 6 diethyl, 4, 6, 7 trimethyl, 5, 5 dipropyl decane. Like this way, just carefully you have to consider, carefully you have to do the calculation, and you have to write the name, UPAC name. Now if up to this, just we have seen different alkyl groups as substitution, isn't it? But now we will see the how different elements can be substituted in alkane. For example, here chlorine is substituted. In that cases, its name will be chloro. Chloro. When iodine, then iodo. When it will be bromine, bromo. Like this way. Bromo, chloro. When it will be fluorine, fluoro. Like this way, other elements can be present there. For example, follow here. Their name will be alphabetical order chloro. So C will be come first and M will be. So from this side, numbering should be from both sides in second position. So alphabetical order chloro will be come first. So 2 chloro, 3 methyl butane according to alphabetical order. Now 1, 2, 3 also same problems and hexane. So 3 chloro, 4 methyl hexane. Now from first carbon this is replaced. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So here will be first carbon 1, 2, 1 iodo, 2, 2 dimethyl butane, like this way. So my dear students, I hope you clearly understood how will you write the UPAC name of different substituted alkanes. Now I have kept here some home practice, just 8 structural formula I have written. You have to write the name. This is not so difficult, this is very easy. Just watching the video properly and attentively, you can easily write the name of these compounds. And please, you will try to write the name of these 8 substituted alkanes, and as early as possible you will send the answer in my personal ID. So today up to this, goodbye everybody, and thank you.